Hello everyone, welcome to AMS Academy. I am Shaurya Gupta. Today we are going to discuss the current affairs of 5 July 2020. Before we move forward, subscribe our YouTube channel AMS Academy and press the bell icon for daily current affairs. Now let's start with today's current affairs. First is senior bureaucrat Sukhbir Singh Sandhu has been given 6-month extension as the chairman of National Highway Authority of India. The Appointments Committee of the Cabinet has approved the extension of Sandhu. Next is Andhra Pradesh Governor Vishwabhushan Harichandan has appointed P. Ramesh Kumar as the State Chief Information Commissioner. These are the first appointments the government made in the Andhra Pradesh Information Commission under the RTI Act. He also appointed Ripala Srinivas Rao as one of the commissioner in the Andhra Pradesh Information Commission. Next is Kalyan Jewellers appointed Sanjay Raghuram as its first chief executive officer, who also holds the position of Chief Operating Officer of the jewelry chain. Also, Salil Nair and Anil Nair have been appointed as directors. Next is All India Radio broadcast its first ever news magazine program in Sanskrit. The program titles Sanskrit Saptahiki. It will be of 20 minutes duration and can be heard at 7:10 a.m. on All India Radio FM channel every Saturday. Next is Housing and Urban Affairs Minister Hardeep Singh Puri launched the toolkit for Swachh Sarvekshan 2021. Mr. Puri also announced a new category of award titled Prerak Daur Samman as a part of Swachh Sarvekshan 2021. Next is DRDO has dedicated to name different wards of new Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel COVID-19 hospital in Delhi after the army troops who lost their lives in Galwan Valley clash. The center with 1000 beds will also have specialized intensive care unit beds and will be fully air conditioned. Next is Indian Air Force and Central Scientific Instrument Organization have developed an indigenous control system for 2 Mi-17 helicopters for spraying atomized pesticides to arrest locust breeding. The pesticide malathion in appropriate concentration would be filled in the internal auxiliary tank of 800 liter capacity fitted inside the helicopter. Next is Government-owned mining majors NLC India Limited and Coal India Limited have formed a joint venture to develop solar and thermal power assets to the tune of 5,000 megawatts of power. Both companies will hold equal 50-50 equity in the joint venture company. Next is researchers at IIT Roorkee have developed a disinfection box that can be used to sterilize personal belongings, medical equipment, PPE, apparels, among others against coronavirus. It is termed as Unisavior box. It comprises a metal coated with specially designed highly reflective geometry to allow the calibrated passage of UVC light to disinfect personal belongings. Next is Odisha government decided to start plasma therapy in the state in 4 of its hospitals for the treatment of COVID-19 patients. A tactical committee would be formed to outline the treatment plan for the therapy. And if we talk about Odisha, capital is Bhubaneswar, CM is Naveen Patnaik and governor is Ganeshi Lal. Next is in Madhya Pradesh, police have started helpline service with the objective to controlling incidents of increased suicides. The purpose of this helpline service is to help the aggrieved person in any way. The helpline service started by Betul District Police has been named Aspas, means around. And if we talk about Madhya Pradesh, capital is Bhopal, CM is Shivraj Singh Chauhan and Governor is Lalji Tandon. Next is a functionality to calculate TDS under Section 194N has been enabled in the Income Tax Department e-filling portal. The service is, however, meant only for officials used by banks, cooperative societies and post office. Next is Equitas Small Finance Bank Limited has launched the facility of opening account through video KYC. This will ensure contactless, no branch visit and hassle-free account opening and transaction for customers. Next is India is expected to add only 60 gigawatt of renewable energy capacity in the next 5 years. According to a Renewable Energy CEO Survey Report 2020 by research and consultancy firm Bridge to India. Next is, India has accumulated the world's fifth largest foreign exchange reserve at more than $500 billion. The reserves were bolstered by a rare current account surplus in the first quarter, a return of inflows in the local stock market and foreign direct investment. Next is, French Prime Minister Edouard Philippe has resigned along with the government. Philippe presented his resignation and that of his government, which was accepted by the president. Next is, Russian President Vladimir Putin has won the resounding victory in his bid to stay in power until the middle of next decade. The vote paves the way for Putin, who has ruled for 2 decades, to remain president until 2036. Next is, Chinese badminton champion Lin Dan, aged 36, announced his retirement. He is 2-time Olympic champion. So this is all for today. If you like it, give me your feedback in comment section. Do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel AMS Academy. Thank you everyone.